Hello and welcome everyone. Once again, welcome to my tutorial series. And in last video, we tried to correct all the bugs that were present inside the scene. And this was the scene after I baked lighting last time. So let's continue from here. And what we will do is we will just closely go and watch all the objects of this scene in this portion of the scene, and instead of this. So let's go there and let's have a look over it. So if I go here and then have a look, what I see is this object still has some bugs. So what I will do is I will just go ahead and have a close look in its mesh tool. So I will go and click here, and then I will go ahead and then I will have a close look on it. It seems okay as of now. Then I will go in UV channel 1, and as I can see, this is quite tilted, and then UV map is not properly distributed in channel 2. Then I will go ahead and then use this tool to distribute the UV channel or map 2 as properly as possible, and then again I will go ahead and I will distribute the UV maps on this again. So now I corrected all the UV on UV map channel 2 on all these objects, and I will correct go and see and then correct. We'll just distribute the UV map on channel 2 as properly as possible by this method, which I taught you in the last tutorial. And after I adjusted all the UV maps on these objects, what we'll have to do is we will have to make sure that this light maps coordinates index on all the objects are 1, because the bug on these objects where their light map coordinates were not 1 and UV map on channel 2 was not properly distributed. So the light map coordinates index of this object is 0 now. I will change it to 1, and then I will go to this object, and then I will open it, distribute the UV map on channel 2. And then I will make the light map, I will cross check light map coordinate index is 1. Since it's not 1, I will make it to 1. And I will have to go through all the objects and make their UV channel and distribute their UV map or UV channel 2 as nicely as possible by using the last technique which I taught you, and make sure the light mass or coordinate light map coordinate index is 1. On this, it's cross checked, and let's go on and cross check on this, it's 1, and on this it's 1. Go ahead and just cross check all the objects, and on this light mass it's 1, it's not 1. I will make it 1. And then I will check on this, it's 0. I will make it 1. and I will, on which I have checked it, I will just go on hiding them to make it simple for me to visualize inside the scene. And I will go ahead, make the UV map, light map coordinate index to 1, and then I will hide it, and then I will go to other object and I will make it to 1 and then hide it, and then I will make it 1 and then hide it. Just go on and just make sure all the objects has light map coordinates index to 1 in their mesh tool, static mesh tool. So now what I did is I just went ahead and distributed the UV map on channel 2 on this object using this mesh tool as properly as possible, and then I went inside this general setting and I made sure that every object had its light map index on 1, because the bug on all these objects in this light fixture was that there was no UV map channel on 2, and all those light map index on all the objects, almost all the objects, were set to 0 because of non-presence of this UV channel. So we went inside max and we unwrapped it second time by converting it into meshes, and then we brought inside the engine again and now once, and we went inside this UV channel 1, and then we redistributed the UV map on channel 2. After that, make sure that all the objects have 1 as light map index on their general setting in mesh tool or a static mesh tool. And after that, let's go on here, and we did something on this object but it's still having problem here. So let's go ahead and have a look over it why it's not been corrected. And once we go inside UV map, I think it's not properly distributed, so let's distribute it as well as possible. So I will use this light map index 1 to distribute the UV map on UV channel 2. And once we go here, this edge is glowing, and to remove this edge glow, let me go ahead and see this here. And once I go ahead and see it, then that the UV map on this edge is not present according to me. So let's go ahead in max and then go on that particular object, isolate it, and then what I will do is I think this I will select all the polygons in here. I will select this whole one polygon and then I will press Ctrl I to invert the selection, and then I will use UV map and I will make it 100, 100, and 100, and then I will convert it into editable mesh, and then I will bring UV AVX exporter, and then I will bring steam roller, and then I will unwrap it one more time. I will go in open UV map, and then I will go in poly, Control A, and then flatten it, and after that I will export it, and then I will go inside Unreal Engine, and then I will press Control B and then right click and then import, and then D drive tutorial, 3D Studio Max, export, traditional, and then I will sort it by date. Make sure that it's sort by date modified, and then I will pick the latest version because I have exported inside and points. I have exported it from 3D Studio Max, so it will be on the top because I have arranged it by date modified. And then I will press yes, and then again I will go inside this mesh tool and then see. I think now it's okay that UV map is okay on this. And let's go and distribute. The UV map on channel 2 properly, and after that let's go ahead and see what's going on this object. So let's go and open this edit. I'll dock it, I'll zoom it. Everything looks okay as of now, but I will go in UV map, and that UV map 2 is just messed up. So I will arrange it again properly, and then what I generally do is I just go on any single portion or single side of any project and I start correcting it side by side. So yeah, there's a glow here, so I will go and then have a look on it why it's glowing. I will check the UV map and then normal flip. Go ahead and cross check it, examine it. I think this is properly aligned. I'll just go in 3D Studio Max. And I will convert it into mesh and then apply a UV map on it. I will copy that UV map to apply on other objects, and then I will unwrap it once again and then go on open UV map and then select all polygons and then flatten mapping. And after that I will export this object also, and then in Unreal Engine Control B and then import and import the latest object present, and then I will go ahead mesh modifier. This is the exact process which I use to correct all the bugs present inside the scene. If you have any better option to bug removal, then go ahead, use your own technique. But if you don't know how to overcome the bugs in your scene, then you can use my techniques. It's quite time consuming, but it works very, very well on large and small, both types of project, and interior and exterior. So I will select this door and then I will press Ctrl Shift and G and open the group, and then I will select this panel and then I will go its mesh tool, and then I will arrange the UV map on channel 2 of that panel, and then I will go and see what's going on here. This is messed up. Let's make it perfect. I don't know why it has been messed up like this. It should not be messed up like the way it has been messed up, but never mind, we can correct them in Unreal Engine, so that's not a big deal. You see this tilted angle, it's not allowed for a bug free object. I use this UV and UV channel 1 and generate light map UVs to remove all the bugs related to UV map. So you can also do that. And what I'm doing right now is I'm just going on every objects and manually generating UV maps by me, by myself, so that to make sure that every object has their UV map in very straight, aligned in a straight angle in UV map. See, this is not absolutely straight, but if I go ahead and then use this technique, it's all the maps are arranged straight. And see, if I go here and then this side, let me correct all the bugs on this side. I'll go ahead and then I will go ahead and arrange all the UV maps on this, all the objects UV map on channel 2 on all the objects. That's the major part of bug removal, and to make the scene ready for a smooth light bake on the objects. So if you want the light to be baked as smooth as possible, then make sure you are arranged all the UV map on channel 2 as straight as possible and as distributed as possible, covering the whole part of the UV channel 2, that is 0 to 1 and or x to y. So if I go closely and look if any object are still rendering in black, then I will go ahead and then arrange the UV map channel on channel 2. Then I just go ahead and then look carefully if I need to work on UV map channel 2 on any specific objects. All these objects in this wooden or this kitchen panel, the edges are black, so I should go ahead and do that on all the objects. So as you can see, I have arranged the UV map on channel 2 of all the object and properly distributed on the whole space available in UV map channel 2 and made those UVs as straight as possible. And I will then close these panels so that my scene will not lag and FPS will not drop. And then I will go on this object and see what's going on. Okay, I think this does not have proper UV map. So let's see the name of this over 2253 and go inside 3D Studio Max 2253 and then apply a map on it, and then apply one more map on here. Select both of these, unwrap them, convert them to editable mesh, and then export them. Come here, Control B, and then import the last two objects because we exported two objects lately, and then go inside your mesh tool and then distribute it as well as possible. It's already been done. Now the UV map seems okay on these objects, and then go on this object, distribute the UV map on this object, And let's go ahead and see this object. You see, if you see a bug or thing like this, that means all the objects, all the other areas are baked properly, but some edges and all those things are black, then the first option is you can just go ahead and increase the resolution of that object and it will be perfectly. And but in last video I said that I always try to avoid increasing resolution of any object, and I try to tend to use as resolution as low as possible. So before increasing the resolution, I will go ahead and arrange the UV map of that object as well as possible, so that I don't have to increase the resolution as a first attempt. And once I do that, and after that also that bug is not gone, then I go ahead and increase the resolution. If you remember, I said this in last video of this tutorial series. So the normal of this object is flipped, so I will go inside 3D Studio Max, and then I will go to that particular object, and that particular object is this cove light, and apply a normal modifier on it, and then I will export it. And then in Unreal Engine I will press Ctrl B and then right click, and then import that last object exported, and then go inside here mesh tool, and then distribute the UV map as well as good as possible. And as you can see that this object, let's see what's going on here. Go in mesh tool and then zoom in on here. Its normals are not flipped, not at all flipped, but UV map I think it's not good. So let's go ahead and arrange the UV map. Use light map index 0, and then distribute the UV map on channel 2. And I think we should do the same for the ceiling lights. Go ahead, have a look on it. UV map seems to be nice, but on UV map channel 2 is just messed up. So I will go ahead and correct it on all the sides. Bug correction, as I said earlier also, is a very time consuming, but that counts and the scene looks. The amount of work you do in correcting the bugs and removing all types of bugs and errors on the objects, that will have an awesome impact in the final baking or final rendering or in the final output of the scene. So my advice will be always go ahead, remove the bug as much as possible, and don't try to steal time and effort there, because that does have a awesome impact in the final delivery. So once I went ahead and corrected the UV map of all the objects on channel 2, we are again ready for a next light bake to see the effect. So now I will go ahead and then make a light build. Before that, I just want to make sure if anything can be worked prior to that. So I think we are ready for the next file build. So now I will go ahead and bake the lighting, and I will see, and we will see how things goes from there after baking light and after correcting this here. Let's see how it goes. So I will meet you on the other side of the light bake. And before light bake, I will try to save the scene for the sake of safety, and then I will go ahead and make sure that it's on medium, and then world setting it's still 0.65, and then I will bake the light and wait for the light to be baked. So after the light has been baked, we'll go inside the scene and we will maximize the viewport and go over all the areas of the scene and have a look that everything has been properly corrected or not. And there seems some error on this object, and I see some error on this object. And then let's go ahead, and I think there is something similar on this object, similar on this object, but on a general level, the scene is coming quite well, and there is some error on this object. So as we have figured out that some work has to be done, so let's go ahead and then see what's going on those objects which still have this error. So I will go ahead and open that object. Yes, this object is normal, is not okay. So let's go inside 3D Studio Max right away, and then I will go on that particular object, and I will apply a normal modifier, export that object, and then I will press Ctrl B, and then I will import that object in the scene again. And now if I go here, that normal is perfect here. Nice. And just cross check that UV map distribution, and then there is a object here which I think also has its normal flipped or something else. Let's see. Go ahead. Normals are okay on this object, but okay, we'll distribute this map on using light map index 1 as of now, and then we will go on this object and then see. Yes, we'll distribute the UV map on channel 2 on this object, and then we will distribute the UV map of channel on this object. This has to be done. There is no shortcut as of now. I will teach you the shortcuts and awesome shortcuts in the next tutorial series. But that has to have Unreal Studio Datasmith. So let's do on this traditional process so that everyone can learn the default way. And I will close these tools so that my FPS don't drop in the viewport, and I will go ahead do the same thing on every object. And once again, as I told lately or earlier, I can go ahead and increase the resolution. That will solve the problem, but that will increase the render time, and that I don't want to do. I don't want to increase the render time. I will have to keep the render time as low as possible so that I can render it in as awesome quality as possible. If you can understand what I mean. And just cross check everything. Yes, these were the two objects which still had some problem. Let's go ahead and once again in UV map channel 2 and see what's going on. I think I will have to apply UV map again. Go ahead and then apply UV map. 25 is, let it be 25, and then once again export both these objects, and then we will import both those objects inside our scene. And then go ahead and then let's make 25 25, and then box, and then 25, make it 25 25 25, and then make it box, and then 25 25, and then 25, and then once again we'll export these two, and then we can just go ahead import both the objects once again, and then if we see UV maps are properly distributed up now, and I see some black this kind of objects. Go ahead and cross check it, hide it for a while. Let's go ahead and this glowing edge has been corrected. Now I will increase the resolution of this object, then I'll go on this, and then it's already been distributed. I will increase the resolution. See, if I have already went inside this object, see, this is edge is coming black, and then for that I will have to go and then cross check that the distribution of UV map on channel 2, it's perfect. I have already used manual distribution of light map, UV map on channel 2, and after that also if this comes, what you have to do is after that you will have to increase the resolution from default to 256, and once you have done this, distributed the UV map on channel 2 properly, and then you will make it 256, then this will be absolutely perfect without any problem. And I think there is a problem on this object, so I will open it and then have a look of the normals are flipped, or maybe the object is flipped. Let's go ahead. Yeah, the both objects are flipped here. I'll go ahead apply UV edit mesh, and then in polygon I will go and then select it, and then I will click show normals, and I think that probably once we have to rotate them, I think we have to rotate them. Okay, this whole object, if I hide it, so what I will do is I will make a group of it. I will select both objects, make a group, then I will unhide it. I will make a group and then I will rotate this. And after I rotate it, I will right click on it and then in transform mirror it on X axis, and I think this will be okay. In the next bake, and once again go ahead and make the resolution of this object to be 256, and just go ahead and watch carefully if anything is left over. I'll close this panels so that my frame rates will not drop. Yeah, once again I have completed this. Let's go on this object TV panel and do the same thing here. And once I have arranged the UV map on channel 2, and after that also object is looking like this or lesser than this, then after that I will increase the resolution. I have, as I have told you guys several times, I am doing the whole process so that you understand how things has to be done and how I correct all the bugs and remove all the bugs and errors to make the scene as look as good as possible. So this has to be done, and it's quite a complex thing, but it can be achieved. So just imagine if I don't tell you guys how to correct all the bugs, and if you get this scene, or if you make any scene and you get all these types of bugs, how difficult it will be to remove all the bugs. So just imagine. So once again our scene is ready for a light bake, and I will go ahead and build the light. And before building the light, I will save the scene for the safety purposes, and I will go ahead and then build the light once again. Then I will come back and see how it goes. So after the light has been baked, once again we will go inside the scene and we will see what's going on. And I think every bug is almost gone inside this portion of the project, but I am seeing a new bug in here. And let me cross check what's going on in mesh editor. I'll go in scene in normal shims. Okay, UV channel 1, and if I test it, okay, we should use the light map index 1 instead of 0 to distribute the UV map on channel 2. So I did that. I think it will be perfect now, and I will go ahead. Arrange the UV map on these two. And then we will go inside this and see. There is a very major problem in this curtain, and in last video I shown you the process, but for a point of revision, I will do that again. So what I have to do is I will have to go inside 3D Studio Max, and then I will go on that curtain. And see what is on. If you can understand, you see this wrinkle thing and wrinkle portion, and this wrinkle portion is here in the on the bottom part of the scene, and this non wrinkle thing is not too much. There is not too much wrinkle. Just see the difference. Just see how the structure is. And once you go in down, see how the structure is. And once you go inside Unreal Engine, what you will see is this object is flipped. It's not it has not come the way it is in 3D Studio Max. So to solve a problem where the object is flipped or moved away from its original location, what you will have to do is I shown you guys in the last video, but again I will show this in this also, this video also. Just go ahead, copy the name of that particular object and go inside this box, and then make a box, create panel, and go inside the create panel and make a box and convert it into editable poly, and then attach this curtain inside this box object. And then copy and paste the name you have copied, and then again paste it, and then go inside element, select that box object, and then delete it. What has happened is the pivot of this object has been messed up, and this may be due to the bug inside 3D Studio Max. And to correct that bug, what I did is I copied the name of the object, I made a box, and once I made the box, this box has its fresh own pivot. And what I did is I converted this box into editable poly, and after converting it into poly, I attached this curtain which had a bugged pivot point. And then what happened is this the bugged pivot point of the curtain lost its identity, and this object became the part of this object because I attached it with this, and this has a very clean and accurate pivot point. And then after that I renamed that object, this object, into that last curtain name. And then after that I delete this box. Then what happened is the pivot of this box came inside this, and this curtain has a new pivot that is fresh and not bugged. And after that I will simply export this object, and then I will import. So just keep a keen eye on this. See, this is like this. And once I go ahead and import this object after correcting the pivot point, see, just keep an eye on that. This object is flipped, and now it's in the same way that is inside Max. So the position and location is the same. So that was a quick tip to convert bugs like that. And once again I will go ahead and correct all the bugs, and you see, you also see that this object also has the same bug. The orientation of this object is wrong and it's not correct. So again I will go and make sure that it is 2140, and then in 3D Studio Max I will go ahead, I will select that object, and then I will copy the name of that object, and then I will go ahead and UV mapped. And if you delete it, and if you argue me that why you are not using. X form, yes, X form. Why you are not using? Because this X form doesn't work on complex, and 98% of the time this XREPS modifier doesn't work. So to make it accurate and 100% perfect in one go, I tried to search for a solution, and I found this solution, and I like this solution too much because it's 100% surety that this is going to work. So I will just go ahead and export it, and I will go inside Unreal Engine and have a look. Okay, then Control B and then right click, import, and import the last object, and you see how well it goes. And then go inside this UV channel and then distribute the object UV, make it 256, and then on the bed what you can see is this bed is not coming well. So what we have to do is we will have to rearrange the UV map on channel 2 once again. So go ahead, select this, and then go and generate UV map, then apply this. Now the map of that bed is properly distributed. So go ahead and do the same on this object also. And then go ahead and do that on this object also. These objects were imported, but in layer panel I had switched off this layer, that's why it was rendering black. And once I was planning how to correct those meshes, then I saw this layer is off, and once I switch it on, then all the objects were present as expected. So let's go on this pillow and then double click it, and then go on UV channel, and then I'm just going on and correcting the UV map on channel 2. On all the objects. I will go ahead and apply a UV map modifier on this object. And I will export it, and then I will import it in Unreal Engine. And in this whole area, you have to just apply all the rules and all the techniques which I told or shown you to use in this area. So if you can see, this area is almost bug free, and I'm going to apply all the techniques which I let you know in the last on the other area of the project. So what I will do is I will just go ahead and apply all the techniques and the rules and the ways which I applied and used to correct all the bugs in this area, and then the only specific things which I used inside this area to correct them on this area. And I will go ahead and correct all the bugs. See, this is flipped, and I will correct this the same way I corrected this object. And I will go ahead and just select all the objects, and then I will apply and redistribute UV map on channel 2 and all those things. And I will just use only techniques which I have already taught. If I encountered any new thing which has to be done to correct any specific bug in this area, I will include that thing inside the next video. But if the object, if the process are the same which I used inside the last other portion, I will not do that, and I will wait for the next video and to include that in the next video. So what I will do is, for the last time today, I will go ahead and bake the light for the last time. Control 2, and I will then bake the last, and then I will bake the light for the last time and see how things are going on this. These two objects, this object and this object, were glass, and I had given the glass material now so that they transmit light and all those things realistically. And I think I should try to correct these two. Okay, let me build the light first. Save it again. I will build the light. So after the light has been baked once again, we will go ahead and cross check. And as I cross check it, everything is absolutely almost bug free here as of now. And if anything is there, like all those things, we will go on in correcting, removing and improving step by step. And this object still has some bugs. I don't know why, but we will make sure that this object don't have any bug. I'm sure that this object UV map or something normal is flipped, or maybe UV channel. For a bit, let's go and have a look on it. Let it be, we will handle them later. We will handle them later. And I'm very happy with the result, the way we have corrected all the bugs. And you can see, and if you remember, you would remember very clearly how this scene used to look before the correction of the bugs and how it looks now. And we corrected some few of the bugs on this area of this project, like this beds and all those things, and they have come quite well here. And I think after correcting this on this curtain, after the correction of that pivot bug, we still need to flip the normal of this curtain. And I will correct all the bugs present inside this scene, and I will proceed ahead from there in the next video. And for today, I will hold this video, because again I have to go for my paid work. And hope you guys to see in the next tutorial. And I really wish that I'm able to make you understand anything, and I really hope that I am able to explain all the things which I want to explain you guys. And if anyone have any type of doubts, or you want clarification, or you want to discuss, or you anything you have to say to me, just reach out to me with the reach out to me in comment section, and we will discuss and we will figure out. And these are all the my process. Some, if you already know the whole process and there is something your own way which you want to discuss, let me know, teach me, or want to learn from me, just go ahead and be in contact, and then discuss with each other and all the other subscriber who want to learn, and help each other to learn the Unreal Engine, to use it inside architecture visualization. So on that note, I will close this tutorial, and I will wish you all good luck and take care. Have fun. Bye bye. GG.